Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Wen. Here is the question. ABC plus BCB equals CDC. All three-digit numbers here. We want to find what is the maximum value of the product of A times B. Now look at this problem. The first thing we can figure out is D less than or equal to 9, because that's a single digit, cannot be bigger than 10. So D less than or equal to 9, we discuss the situation based on D. D equals 9, next number we should discuss D equals 8, D equals 7, and so on. Also, we can find A plus B equals C. A plus B equals C here, right? This column. So here we can also imply C plus B equals D, B plus C equals D. We also can imply B plus C cannot be bigger than 10. If it is bigger than 10, you can see BC sum here, BC sum here. That means this part should be D plus 1. If it is D, that means C plus B, B plus C is a single number, not two digit number. So here you don't carry any one in front column, same situation here. So A plus B equals C. A plus B equals C, we imply B must be less than C because B plus A equals C. We use those kind of relationship and list on the table, we discuss the situation. It will be easy to figure out the solution. So consider D equals 9 first, then consider D is less than 9. So here is the table. Now, when D is fixed at 9, then we consider B. D is fixed here, it's 9. Then consider B. What kind of B value can be? B can be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 until 9. Okay. So we consider one by one. B equals 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then we can continue to discuss the remaining part. So if B equals 1, and D equals 9, B equals 1, D equals 9. So one number plus B equals 9. That should be 8. Sorry, it should be 8. So 8 plus 1 is 9. Now, what is A value? We need to find the maximum product of A times B. What is A? A is here. A plus B equals C. We already find that C here. What is B? B equals C minus A. C minus A. We already figured out B here. B is fixed. So A equals C minus B. C, this column minus this column equals this column. So that's 8 minus 1 is 7. 7 minus 2 is 5. 6 minus 3 is 3. 5 minus 4 is 1. So we figured out A column based on this formula. A equals C minus B. So now we have A here, we have B here, we can find the last column. 7 equals 1 times 7, right? A times B here is 7. And here there's 5 times 2 is 10. 3 times 3 is 9. 1 times 4 is 4. So now here, why we stopped here, let me mark it. So what number we should put here? That's 4. Right? So based on this condition, B less than C. But here, B bigger than C, right? here B bigger than C. Is that right? So B less should be less than C. The remaining part we should not consider. So after that, we don't consider the remaining part. This is the case when D equals 9. Now, how about D equals less than 9? So here, less than 9. Consider D equals what? 8 first. D equals 8. What does that mean? So here, the D value from 9, we drop the to what? To 8, right? So B is still same thing here. What is C? So B plus C equals D. Because D dropped the 1 unit. So C should be dropped 1 unit. So C should be minus 1 here, right? Every number. So minus 1 here, that should be 7. Minus here, that's 6. Minus here, that's 5. Minus here should be 4, right? And A is also original A because A plus B equals C. A plus B equals C. C reduced by 1. B doesn't change. So A should be minus 1, right? So here that should be 6. And here should be 4. Here should be 2. Here should be 1. So here A times B is what? This time this, that should be 6. And this 4 times 2, that's 8. And 2 times 3, that's 6. And 1 times 4, that's 4. Oh, sorry, here should be 0. So that's 0. A cannot be 0, right? A cannot be 0. This kind of situation doesn't exist. So here you can see when we reduce D by 1, when D equals 8, D equals 7, D equals 6. So any situation when D equals 9, we don't discuss. Because their product, all product of A times B less than this number. So this number is the number we want, right? So here, that's the conclusion. Let me clean up. That's the conclusion, yeah. I did not clean up. Yes, so this is the conclusion. Thanks for watching and see you next time.